How do I fix the master boot record? Everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Simple question. Can you tell me how to fix the MBR, as I've never had to do it? The MBR, or master boot record, is the very first sector of MBR-configured hard disks. GPT-configured hard disks have something similar, but I'll just be referring to MBR unless the difference really matters. In either case, it tells the BIOS or UEFI where on the hard disk to locate the software that's supposed to be loaded when you boot your computer. Without an MBR, or with a damaged MBR, your machine won't boot. It can't power up, it can't load the operating system. There's a lot more to booting than just the MBR. Fortunately, recent versions of Windows have made the distinction between these various pieces fairly transparent, referring to them all as Windows Startup. I'm not sure what led you to ask about fixing the MBR, but repairing Windows Startup will address MBR problems as well as some others. So, recent version of Windows now includes something called Startup Repair, which attempts to fix several processes that can cause a machine to fail to boot. Fixing the MBR is just one of them. The first logical question to ask is, if you can't boot the machine, how do you run the boot repair tool? You boot from something else. Specifically, you can boot from a system repair disk, the disk you create beforehand when the operating system was running, or you can download a Windows setup disk for your version of Windows, which also has these tools. I'm going to assume the setup disk, since that's more common and you can download it when you need it. What we're looking at here is just that. It's the Windows 11 setup disk that I recently downloaded from Microsoft. All right. Boot from that Windows setup disk. You'll, of course, be asked languages, time, currency, set whatever appropriate for you, and click on Next. Keyboard input method, same thing. Choose what's appropriate for you and click on Next. Now, here's where we start making some different choices. You have the option to install Windows 11, which is not what we want to do, or you have the option to repair your PC, which is exactly what we want to do. We'll click on Next. Again, it needs to choose the keyboard layout again, I guess. Here we are. Now we have some options to choose from. If you didn't mean to do any of this, you can continue and boot to Windows 11. What we're going to do instead, however, is click on Troubleshoot. In Troubleshoot is exactly what we want. This is called Startup Repair. We'll click on that. Choose a target operating system. Most of the time, you will have only one. Now, prior to getting to this, you may have been asked for a Bitlocker recovery key. If your disk is Bitlocker encrypted, then you'll need to provide that key here. The article associated with this video actually has an example of that. The bottom line is you need the recovery key. Hopefully, you should be able to locate it in your Microsoft account at aka.ms/myrecoverykey. However, in this case, I'm not BitLocker encrypted, so we're bypassing that step. This is what you would see next if you successfully entered the recovery key to a BitLocker encrypted drive. Choose a target operating system. Well, you'll probably only have one. If you've got more than one, you should pick the one that you want boot by default and click on that. And it starts diagnosing. Now, this can take a little while or not, but it does go through all of the checks that I believe Windows can do automatically. And you can see that it says it couldn't repair your PC. In my case, it couldn't repair it because there was nothing to repair. I ran through this on a working system. You may have other information at this point. The thing to do is to hit Advanced Options, and then exit and continue to Windows 11. That way you'll see if the repair actually repaired the problem that you're facing. Now, I also want to cover the other way to do these things, and that is to use the command line. It's my assumption that Startup Repair, that I've just shown you, runs the same tools I'm about to talk about, but running them manually, we might get some more diagnostic information if things aren't working, even if that's only information to provide to a repair technician later. So, instead of hitting Continue, we'll click on Troubleshoot again, And this time, we'll click on Command Prompt. Use the command prompt for advanced troubleshooting. And indeed, there's a command prompt. Now, the first command we're going to type in is bootrec space slash fixmbr. It completed successfully. Actually, it doesn't really tell you much. In this case, on this machine, I don't think it did anything. The good news here is that it didn't fail. So if it failed, that would have probably given you information that might have been useful. Fixmbr is probably about MBR disks. So we need to also run tools that might operate on GPT formatted disks. In that case, we start with bootrec slash fixboot. Access is denied. That's okay. We'll skip this because the next one we're going to do is slash rebuild BCD. BCD is the boot configuration data used by newer boot processes like GPT slash UEFI. Successfully scanned. Found zero installations. Honestly, I believe it found zero additional installations because indeed there is an installation of Windows on here. But these three commands run in sequence that I've just shown you could, if things are failing, give you additional data that may be useful. Ultimately, what happens next is kind of beyond the scope of this video. Hopefully, you'll have some data you can take to a technician that would give you more information, or actually more hopefully, you'll have a working system because startup repair, which is really all that's necessary, probably fixed something for you. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/104130. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.